Hey, good morning, guys. It's Sunday. Well, might not be Sunday. For me, it's technically Saturday. For you guys, it might be Monday. I don't know when you're going to be watching this, but hopefully around Sunday. It's good to see you again. I missed last week. I don't have much of an excuse. I don't remember why I didn't make a video, but I'm back this week, and I'm excited. It's been a pretty good week, so I'm glad I was able to do it. I was able to find some alone time with God. I was able to get a decent amount of work done. I felt more accomplished this week than I have the last few weeks, and I'm really happy to be making this video. I also found a new place to hike. Well, that's not entirely accurate. A new place to hike isn't what I mean to say. I actually went to a place where I've been tens of times. I've probably been 50 times at least. And instead of turning right when the trail cuts off to make a loop, I turned the other direction and took the trail backwards from what I normally take it. Now, there's not a right way or a wrong way to go down the trail. It's not marked for one specific direction. I just always go one way. But going this other direction really breathed new life into the trail. It made it feel completely different. I noticed things I'd never noticed before. There were times where, even though I wasn't lost, I didn't like go off the trail and get myself lost in the woods. I didn't know exactly where I was. Like, I couldn't tell you how far I'd traveled because my normal landmarks were backwards. And I, you know, looked different directions into the woods and saw different animals, different trees, different parts of the trail, different things that I hadn't noticed before that have always been there. But because I was always going one way, I never got a handle on those things. And it was pretty cool. And I'd been thinking about it a lot this week, because this happened Tuesday or so that this happened. And I've been thinking about it ever since. There's actually, It's neat that it happened, because it fit really well into the video I was supposed to make last week, which I'm now doing this week. In Acts, there's a story very similar, and by very similar, you'll understand that in a minute, but like, none of the apostles took a trail the wrong way and had a different perspective. But it's a story about Peter, and I'll post a video, a link to it in Slack. Well, actually Miss Karen, well, she's been awesome, but she'll post a video to it, to the story. But to sum it up briefly, Peter's going to the synagogue after Pentecost, and on his way in, he notices a man that everyone knows who he is. He's been there for a real long time. If you asked anyone, hey, do you know who that person is? They'd be like, oh yeah, that's that guy. And he was a crippled beggar that begged outside very often. He was not a stranger. Everyone knew who he was. This time, though, when he was asking for money and Peter walked by, Peter had a completely different perspective on him. He didn't just pass by. He didn't just give him money if he ever gave him money. Instead, because the Holy Spirit lived in Peter now, since it was after Pentecost, the man was healed. And it's an incredible story of change, because before, it's not like Peter didn't want to heal the man before. It's not like Peter saw him and was like, oh, I gotta ignore that guy. It's not like that. Just the fact that the Holy Spirit was in him gave him an entirely new perspective on what he was supposed to do. Just like how me randomly turning one way down a trail made me see entirely different things. I didn't magically become a better trail walker, but something changed. The way I was walking changed, and I saw everything completely different. And that's exactly what happened to Peter, but in a much more powerful and meaningful way. This week, similar to the last time I made a video, I really want you to try and focus on living this out in your everyday life. But we're gonna be a little bit more specific this time. When I pray, I want you guys to pray and think about specific places where the Holy Spirit is calling you to live out your life for God, and use the power of the Holy Spirit to use that perspective. And I don't know where anyone's going these days. I'm not really going much of anywhere. But if you're going to school, if you're going to McDonald's, if you're going to different activities, if you're going to church and you're watching this video in addition to going to church on Sunday, but wherever you're going, think about those places and ask God to show you where specifically he wants you to use that perspective. where he wants you to see things differently and have the opportunity to see things like he sees them. Not just as a crippled beggar on the side of the road, but as someone that God wants you to heal. Not just as, you know, right or left on a trail, but as a completely different view of the world. I'm going to pray real fast and then I'll let you go. Heavenly Father, thank you for these wonderful kids. Thank you for sending us the Holy Spirit to get your perspective on the world, to help us when we don't know what to do or how to act. I pray that you will give clarity to everyone watching this, that you will show them a place that you want them specifically to live out their love for you and to see the world as you want them to see it, God. Keep them safe this week. Help them have a fun, good week. Be with them and their families. In your name we pray. Amen. Thanks, guys. It was good to be back. Hopefully, I'm trying to find other things to do besides these long videos to get in contact with you. I'm probably going to take some advice that Karen gave me and try and give you a few of you calls. And I haven't forgot the other things I'm trying to do, like Minecraft. They just had to take kind of a back burner while I found a new balance. But thanks for being patient with me. I love you and miss you guys a lot. Have a good week. Bye.